Hello everyone, in this video, I'll show you how to turn your Blender 3D models into a sprite sheet with this add-on called 2D Factory. With just one click, you can turn your model's animations into a game-ready sprite sheet. Not only that, this add-on can also generate back texture for the sprite sheet, control pipettes, export JSON files, and more. And now, let me walk you through how it all works. So first, installation of this add-on is simple. Just go to Edit, Preference, Add-on, then click Install, and find the zip file of the add-on. After that, you'll find the add-on right in your side panel. The workflow of using this add-on starts in the camera section, where you need to select the target model. From here, the add-on gives you full camera control. You can adjust the camera utilizing the spherical coordinates by tweaking this axis, the radial distance, the polar angle, and the azimuthal angle. If you need more adjustment, the sliders under the camera offset can be used for panning. To ensure sprites stay consistent in size, the add-on includes a 2D ruler overlay. Just enable it right here, these lines will appear on the camera screen. This way, you can easily tell the size of the sprite by adjusting these 4 sliders. Another essential feature given by this add-on is pipot placement. Enabling this feature right here will add a pipot marker on the frame. You can move it precisely with these XY sliders, and the pivot values will be saved by the add-on as metadata in the JSON file. Okay, now let's go to the rendering tab. At the very top here, you'll need to specify the folder path of your sprite sheet. Make sure to write the correct path, because the add-on will automatically reject if that path is wrong. You can type a new folder name at the very end. Even if such folder doesn't exist yet, the add-on will create it automatically. Next is the actions list. This is where you add the animations that you want to turn into the sprite sheets. Click the plus button to add the slot, then select an action from the dropdown. Only actions that belong to your model will work here. You can add as many actions as you need, and remove them with the minus button. If your model already has lots of actions, you can use this menu, list all actions, and the add-on will populate them automatically. Next is the direction setting. This controls how many angles you want your model is rendered from. And direction here is calculated by taking into account of your current camera view. For example, choosing two directions will render the current view plus the opposite side at 180 degrees. Next, under the frame render preference, we have two options, sweep keyframe and skip last keyframe. By default, the add-on only renders the keyframes of your animations. In other words, it skips the in-between frames. Now, if you enable sweep keyframe, it will instead render every frame from the first keyframe to the last, giving you a smoother sprite animation. The second option is skip last keyframe. This option is useful if your animation is meant to loop, because in many cases, for a looping animation, the first and last frames are the same, which would create a duplicate frame. By enabling this option, the add-on automatically skips the final frame, giving you a perfect seamless loop. But to tell the add-on which action should loop, you simply check the mark looping box next to the action in the list. Any action marked this way will automatically skip the last frame during rendering, and the exported JSON file will include the metadata that this action is a looping animation. And just to the right of the mark looping option, you'll see a drop-down menu. This lets you mark how the action animation should be played in game, be it forward, reverse, or ping-pong. So basically, this option is like directions option in the Sprite. Keep in mind, this setting doesn't change the render itself. Instead, this information is just saved in the JSON metadata. Finally, let's look at the last option in the rendering tab, which is include back. If you enable this checkbox, you'll see a list of texture back options appear just below it. You'll just need to check which texture back option you want to include during rendering. Next to each back option, there's also a preview button. Clicking it will generate the big and show the result directly in Blender's image editor. And for your information, baking can work both on the orthographic and perspective camera view. If you check the normal bake, you'll notice an extra drop-down below it, where you can choose whether the normal map should be in DirectX or OpenGL format. And just under the bake options, there is the recommended settings checkbox. Turning this on will automatically reinforce some optimized cycle settings. These settings are designed to speed up baking without losing quality. At this point, if you're ready to make your spreadsheet, simply press the Execute Renderer button, and the add-on will take care of everything. The rendering will also respect whichever render engine you've chosen in Blender, so you can choose to use Eevee or Cycles. Now, if you prefer not to include an action at all, and just render by specific frames, you can enable this Custom Render Keyframe option. When you enable it, the action list box will be replaced by two new fields, the action name box and the keyframe box. In the action name box, simply specify the name of the action you want to assign to this custom render. Then, in the keyframes box, you can type the exact frames you want to render. For example, the default value already filled here will render frames 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Or if you want to render the entire active timeline, just type a semicolon. After that, just hit the execute render and the add-on will generate the sprites for the inputted frames. Okay, now let's take a quick look at the export settings. Normally, if we render just as it is, the camera will capture the entire frame, including a lot of empty space around the object. But 2D Factory add-on has an auto-cropping feature which can be enabled if you click this outer button. After the render, the add-on will automatically crop the rendered image based on the transparent background. Just keep in mind, because it relies on the transparency, you need to make sure background transparency is enabled in Blender under Render, Film, Transparent. You can also fine-tune the crop area with the Expand Auto Crop box, which lets you add clearance or a padding around the detected area. If you prefer not to crop at all, just select None instead. And finally, for more control, there is 2D ruler option, and if you enable the 2D ruler in the camera tab and then select it here, the add-on will crop the image down to the center area defined by the ruler. This is useful if you want a consistent crop region across all renders. Now, this add-on offers two types of output for the spreadsheet, a single and a separate. If your usual workflow is to produce a single sheet with a JSON file, the single option here is the right one. Now let's see what happens when we run the render with the single option. As you can see, if we render one action at a time, each new action will be stitched to the bottom of the existing spreadsheet. But if we re-render an action that's already in the sheet, it won't create a duplicate. Instead, it will update that action with the new version. Updating will override the previous sheet, but don't worry, if you make a mistake, you can recover the other sheets inside the reserve folder here. Now, if you choose the separate option, the spreadsheet will be created individually for each action and stored in its own texture along with the baked textures. But the JSON file will not be produced, but instead, the required metadata will be encoded directly in each spreadsheet file name. The separate option is very useful if your rendered image has a big resolution, because if you stitch them all into one single spreadsheet, the resolution can quickly become very large, and many game engines limit texture size to 16K. Now, 2D Factory add-on also provides a free Unreal Engine plugin that automates sprite extraction if you choose this separate option. Once you install this plugin in the Unreal Engine, a custom menu will be added when you right-click on the texture, a folder, or even a blank space inside a folder. This makes workflow very fast, because you only need to drag all the action folders you've produced into Unreal Engine Content Browser, and then just execute the custom menu. Then, the plugin will scan all spreadsheets in your action folders containing the metadata in its file name. then produce to extract the sprites and flipbooks automatically, and also assign the baked textures into their correct slots. Once finished, the metadata will be sanitized from the file name. We will explain more about this plugin in detail inside the documentation and in the next video. Finally, we provide the link to the add-on in the description of this video, so feel free to check it out and try it for yourself. And that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.